What is up, guys? Welcome back to the ONDGAS show. And today you get your boy Tiny. But if you don't like Tiny, if you don't like Acosta, if you don't like Frank or Perrillo, switch the channel, go watch or something. But anyways, with that being said, my boy Perrillo is excited because he is taking the truck out to Flaco to get a little tune. I don't know what all Flaco's gonna do to it. I don't know if Flaco's even ready for it. Because I mean, I don't know if this truck's 100%, Frank. I mean,
I made sure with Alex and everybody else who was part of this build, is the truck ready to get tuned, Alex? He says it is. He swears it is, so I hope it really is.
I mean, luckily my boy Flaco, he's part of, you know, the whole ONDGAS team here, and he understands us a little bit, but I know some of these tuners get a little bit pickier when something's off or a little sensor's off because it complicates things while they're tuning it. Hopefully we don't have that issue here. But well, my boy Alex is strapping the truck, guys. I want to talk about real quick the giveaway that's going on right now that is live. And this giveaway, as you know, as you've seen, it is a 454 OBS Classic truck that you could be taking home. This is a 1 week giveaway from Sunday to Sunday, and it ends this Sunday, May 12th. Now, the way to get entered, guys, is simple. All you have to do is head over to ondgas.com. You choose one of the two options that we have. Well, technically, it's three options with the combo package. Now, you have the decal, which is gonna give you 50 entries. You have the shirt that's gonna give you 100, or the combo package that gives you 200. Now, we also had that license plate cover, but unfortunately, like my boy Beto was saying, if you didn't get it in time, we only had limited quantities, it sold out. And we're not gonna oversell because we don't want you guys waiting for them to receive them and get all that email and all that crap. So they're sold out, unfortunately. So stay tuned, hopefully here in the next few months, the next month and a half, somewhere around there. Stay tuned to our social media on Instagram, Facebook, and you'll see when they pop back up online if you're still interested in one of those. But with that being said, guys, the giveaway, the 454 OBS truck. Now, we gave you guys a quick rundown the other day on it. It's super clean from head to toes, from front to end, undercarriage, big 454 with a cam, with a nice exhaust, clean interior, the nice 17 by 11s. You're taking the nice 17 by 11s, and you're taking home a little piece of ONDGAS history, a little piece of ONDGAS memorabilia, you could say, because these wheels were the first wheels that were on the sound truck. Now, the sound truck, as you've seen, has come a long way from when we first had it. It was on this channel the beginning of the stages, right, Frank? When we bought it, and it had like those Northside wheels sound?
Yeah, it's been actually on the first official YouTube video, the truck comes out in the background, 2020.
2020, so it's been something that's been carried through our channel for a while, and you guys are gonna be lucky enough to take something home that belongs to the ONDGAS history. So get your entries in, ondgas.com, May 12th, it ends. And the best thing of this, if you don't like this style of truck, if you're not a Chevy guy or anything, I love these trucks since I was a youngin', since I was, you know, in elementary, I was 5'5", about 250 pounds, since I was about that age, you know?
Holy fucking shit.
I was a big boy in elementary, so my boy Acosta over there laughing, you know? Yeah, I was a big boy in elementary. But I mean, back then, these trucks were like the ones to have. And hell of a truck that you guys get to take home with a clean paint job. Yeah, with that being said, guys, let's see what my boy Perrillo is doing. He seems a little excited. He was running a little late earlier today. I think he has some things to do here, but.
Bagdad trailer, almost.
You should have, bro. You know what I mean?
Special occasions or what?
Yeah, I mean, this truck should be riding on a bagged out trailer, you know. Now, one thing that I haven't been here to the shop in a while because, you know, your boy Tiny trying to get fit and trying to work out, you know. But one thing that I see here is a new addition, Frank. Did you give a rundown on this trailer yet?
We haven't. No one has seen it yet on the channel or Instagram, but we did get a new merchandise trailer, and this motherfucker is huge.
Now, this thing is, dude, should we show him? Should we show him?
We could, but it's locked and everything.
Well, we'll just give him a quick outlook on the outside of it. Now, we got a new merch trailer. And in the previous video, you see our own merch trailer over there in the back. I don't know if you can see it, but there's some panels missing, wheels fell off. Now, to give you a quick rundown on it, back in, I think it was OTM, right? It was OTM. It was October Truck Madness when we had it the first time at Texas Motor Speedway. You know, we took the trailer out there fully loaded with merch and everything. It was kind of heavy. I pulled it out there myself. I went ahead and went out before the whole team because I wanted to set up before it. And when I was getting there midway, I broke a leaf spring. A leaf spring broke and the whole wheel shifted, the whole axle shifted, all that crap. So luckily I was able to get it fixed at a truck stop out there, right? And then panels were flying off. There's panels that are missing on it. Panels flew off, so, you know. And then when I ended up pulling up to Texas Motor Speedway, one of the hubs was going out. You know, I was literally probably an hour away, but I said, ride it. Y'all rode it. I wasn't gonna stop. It was dark. When we got to the venue, the hub was completely about to fall off. So I think that day, luckily my boy Tito, I think Buffalo and Chop, they went out and they got the wheel hub. You know, my boy Tito, he was a little stressed out because I was making him work and, you know, he was fixing things out and, you know, of course, giving me hard times like always. And they got it fixed, right? So the whole event went down and everything was good. And on the way back, Tito wanted to come back early. So he's like, you know what? I'm gonna hook up to the merch trailer and bring it back because we had plenty of trailers. So he came back early I think somewhere in Huntsville, he lost the wheel. He lost the wheel, which Huntsville is probably what, like an hour and a half from here, Frank?
Yeah, give or take, it's still far from here.
Yeah. It's about an hour and a half. If y'all have people over there in Huntsville, like in the jailhouse over there or whatever, you know what I'm talking about. But anyways, he lost the wheel. He said he lost the wheel. He said, fuck it. He kept going. He noticed that the wheel was already cambering a lot, but he said, I'm getting home. He lost the wheel. He got pulled over because he was riding on the highway with a, riding on the road with just a rotor on the ground. One wheel like that, just scraping an hour and a half away. He got pulled over by a state trooper and he pretty much told the state trooper, hey, I'm taking it all the way. And the state trooper said, be careful. And he just hit it. And he arrived here. You wanna go show him?
Yeah, let's go show him how fucked up it is.
He arrived here like pretty much bare metal, like bare metal. And he didn't give a damn. He was trying to get home. But yeah, let me show you real quick.
This is what we're talking about, the panels flying off and everything getting fucked up.
Yeah. I mean, the trailer put in work, but you can see right here, we lost the wheel. This one was about to give out. As you can see, the if you could really get a good look at it, it's kind of twisted already. And on the other side, I don't want to get over there because we had, I mean, my boy Butt Lighter Ferrillo ain't cut the grass, but the other side, the other panels, they have a whole bunch of black duct tape as well. This trailer has come a long way. I think you bought this, you and Lawrence went out to get it. When was this, Frank?
In Georgia, we went to Georgia to go pick it up in 2016 or 2015. So it's been, we've been putting work with this trailer for about 9 years now. Yes. Eight, 9 years.
It served this purpose. It served this time. I mean, you know, God bless, rest his soul. I think my boy Tito wants it for some reason. I mean, he's that type of guy that wants it and wants to fix it and take care of it. But we just had a fan pass by screaming. But that trailer served its purpose. It did what it did. And we're very blessed now convert to this. Now look at it. Look at the comparison. This is the Carhartt. This is where crawfish, moonshine, all the big race trucks go in, all the good stuff, all the expensive stuff goes in this. Now compare this to the merch trailer.
Yeah.
Look how big it is.
This one has like 9 foot ceilings and really? This one has a 7 foot. So that's why it's so tall.
And the purpose of that is because we have some big people around here. You have me, you have Machete, you know what I mean? My boy Profe, sometimes he gets a little big, he's a little wide, you know, but like we're all big people out here. You know, the camera really doesn't do justice till you see us in person. The only short person that you probably see is Wakala, you know, and that's pretty much it. And the comparison is badass. It's huge. Right now we don't have the keys for it. It's all locked up inside. But I see 2 concession windows. Now, I don't think we'll sell out of it, but we use those concession windows to move merch around and everything. And then I think we need to get a, I think we're still gonna go with a carpenter inside to try to get shelves put in and all that, right? Try to make it look real nice like we did that one. Well, that one was kind of, you know what I just noticed? Why is there a table on top of it?
I don't know.
It's, you see it? Like it's literally on top of it.
How did that even get up there? Somebody chucked the table up there.
I know, it's like, I just noticed the table's up there for some reason. Like. But anyways, we're gonna get a carpenter in here to get all the shelves put in there. So makes it real easy for us when we sell merch and try to tend to you guys as quickly as possible. Now, Perrillo is on a time crunch. He needs to get over to Flaco because Flaco is on point and it's scheduled time. And he's running a little late, right?
He was supposed to be there at 4 and it's actually 4 o'clock right now.
Yeah, so he's probably gonna get there at 5:30 because he has to move in all the other rides. And another exciting thing, guys, I have Black Sugar right here too. Black Sugar is back. I turned it on earlier this morning. I am gonna head over to Trust Auto right now and go get a drive shaft for it. I'm gonna go drop it off on my boy at Juan's Transmission. Big shout out to him. He's always been supporting me, always supporting the team. He is gonna convert it to a 2-wheel drive. And I know you guys say, man, it's a SS, it's a stay all-wheel drive. I get it, but the way it's low, I just have issues. I could correct it by putting upper lower control arm, spending a whole bunch of crap on it, spent $2,500, $3,000 just for a suspension to ride like that. But in reality, I wanna fishtail a little bit on it. And I want the offset wheel look. I want the 24, 26 setup. I always like that setup. So I think the best option for me is to convert it to 2-wheel drive and then drop it off tomorrow. And hopefully here in the next few days, it's 2-wheel drive and I'll be able to cruise it around. You'll be seeing me out there Sunday one day, probably with my girl or something. You never know.
You had to say that, Tidy.
Yeah. But with that being said, guys, this vlog, we're gonna let Perrillo get all the vehicles in there. So we're gonna let Perrillo go in there and shut everything down. And he's gonna take over the vlog. So we got a couple things we need to do ourselves. And the rest of the day, you're gonna get the Perrillo cam. But remember, giveaway ends today in a matter of a few hours. 11:59 p.m. is the cutoff time. Get your entries in to take that truck. Doesn't get better, guys. And remember, that's the last giveaway we're gonna do for a while because ONDGAS is gonna go on a tour and we don't have time to do the giveaways, unfortunately, at this time. So maybe in a month or two, we'll pop in with another giveaway, but take your advantage of this time, this one right now. I'll see you guys next week sometime.
Alright guys, so we're here on the highway heading over to Flaco's. We're a little late, you know, like the usual, you know, just I'm always late. But we got everything done, we got everything taken care of over there at the shop. We're heading to Flaco's for 2/4/20. The fucking day is finally here. The day. Today is a special day. It would have been cool if I tuned it on 420. 420 tuned on 420. But you know, it didn't happen. So we're doing it right now. We're gonna see what kind of numbers we can push on this, because I got a pending race with Flaco, and I wanna beat Flaco. So y'all follow me here to this journey. And we're out here at Flaco's, and you know, thing about Flaco, if you come to Flaco, you wanna have a good relationship with them, make sure you bring a Red Bull and chocolate. So let's go give him a little, his little goodies, you know what I'm saying? Just like that.
Yeah, just like that.
What's up?
Hey man, I still got some chocolate from last time.
This guy, este vato si me quiere.
¿Para Christmas?
Este vato me quiere, wey, o que es lo que, okay, he wants me to put the sauce on the truck.
That's what you want?
I know, he
bought me some. No, Hershey's but milk, didn't have chocolate. It. That didn't happen.
Look, sneakers, almonds, and an extra tall Red Bull. This guy wants all the sauce.
Hey, you know they're 2 for $5, right?
Este vato, he wants all the sauce. Yeah.
Alright guys, so we have a very, very special treat going on right here. I got called out by Flaco yesterday. When you get called out by Flaco, that's not good. You're gonna lose. Vamos a sacar todos los winners a la troca. A ver qué trae. All the nitrous, all the juice, whatever. Que truene. Fuck it. No, que no truene. Yo no soy Beto, espérate. We're gonna try and get as much power out of it as we can with the tune and everything. Everything's right. The truck is 100%. So.
Are you 100%?
I think I am. 100% what?
Ready.
Oh, I thought you were gonna say something like 100% gay or something.
No, 100%.
Yeah. All right, 100%. But we're getting there. We're getting there. Yo, a ti me va a tunear la mente, Flaco. ¿No sabías?
También haces.
No, tunea todo el compadre.
This intake, it's been a little whore, actually.
Hey!
It's been passed around. It used to be on crawfish. This is the original intake when crawfish was a 6.0 big turbo. Then it was on brownie, and now it's here on Perrillo's 408.
It's like the I'm joking.
You got me.
So, we're here with Flaco. Really, really, really excited for this, because not only because I've been working on this truck, but I've been trying to tune it, trying to get it running and everything for a while. So big shout out to Velocity for doing everything, bro. They did everything. They installed me a catch can. They installed me standalone fuel system. They installed the motor, fresh wiring. Everything's loomed up. So big shout out to Velocity for doing all that, especially the intake and the pipe in the front, you know? So I'm really excited. I'm really excited. I don't know what kind of numbers it's gonna push. I'm excited, Acosta. We got Acosta behind the camera.
Over here.
What's up, Acosta? I'm excited for you.
Are you licensed?
No, I'm not licensed yet. You're licensed.
I'm licensed.
You are now licensed.
I am now licensed. I don't know what to say. I'm a little bit lost for words. This truck has been in the works for a while. Y'all can see the way this truck started. If y'all watched the past videos, this truck was a 6.0 swap. Not the greatest, you know. I am really thankful for the opportunity that Beto and Frank gave me. Let's not forget that. This truck was a gift from throughout the years that I was working with them prior to the YouTube stuff. And I've been working with the guys for a little bit over six or seven years. So big shout out to Beto, Frank. Appreciate it for y'all making this happen, because without them, I wouldn't be in the position that I'm at right now.
What you thought?
Yeah, just going through it now.
You gotta work on your own truck.
I never thought I'd see the day. And I actually do have the cam specs and all that. That way you can go over it and all that kind of. I had to get it, you
What's
know?
What's that grunt for?
The fans.
What's this wire for?
which for fans.
What's this wire for?
Hey, Flaco, don't put me on a reel, bro. Don't put me on a reel, all right?
For real?
I don't got speakers hanging out the window, all right?
So what does that wire do?
It's just grounded. That way, whenever I'm driving, the fans work. Yes, sir.
So what about whenever we're not driving?
No.
Like standing still?
No, I think they're showing up, but here's all the cam and everything.
I had to, bro.
I don't want to be in a reel. I saw that reel. I got too many views. too many views for comfort.
Look right here.
Yeah.
Are you doing other progressive shit?
I don't know here.
Other progressive actor stages?
Probably.
Or just a simple tune?
No, on that. You can do two different tunes.
Yeah. Check with Flaco to see.
Hey, what's that screen right there?
That's your Nitrous screen?
That's the Pro Max Progressive Kit. See you guys, see me.
See, you even got a wide band, boy. Yeah. Me tanto viene listo, wey. He's ready.
Ooh.
Yeah, man. That's 1 point.
The worst thing is a dead battery.
Oh, no, you hate that.
Like, if you're in the middle of tuning, and then you, like, put the key forward to download or whatever, and then the battery goes dead, dude, that is, like, the worst.
All right, guys, so we're sweating a lot. Like I said, it's hot. This is what my boy Russell did. He told me about this, and he told me to tell Flaco before he even tunes it. Talk about this wire right here. So this one, he just did it just so the fans will run right now, but took it off, you know, just so the fans don't drain the battery. I do got a badass battery, but still, we took it off. That way it don't drain the fans. You don't want a dead battery. That's the worst.
Did you sleep last night?
Yeah.
And you're not excited?
I'm very excited.
You don't even know what the hell that is.
I'm a retard.
Look, here's the thing.
Fine.
Listen.
I'm going to be honest with you. I'm kind of retarded.
No, well then the reason is because, I'm going to tell you why. The reason because whenever you're going to run it on nitrous, well, on motor, you're going to be running with less timing. If you had with the retard box, when you turn the nitrous on, then it kicks the timing down. See, because then when I beat you, you're going to be like, man, it's because I was on nitrous timing.
Here we go. Damn, bro. I just can't even get a tune. I'm getting chopped, huh?
You know what I mean?
Yeah,
he said, where's my retard box? He said, where's my retard box?
I thought you were it.
So, I can still spray it, but then you won't be able to spray it. Like, I can, but then you won't until you put the retard box, and then we put the timing that it needs to be retarded back. Because that'll be the best thing.
So, for now, it's just going to be an all-motor tune. Play safe.
Say if you put 10 degrees, it's gonna retard 10 degrees from what the motor has.
But we can do an all motor tune, right?
Yeah, we'll do all motor tune.
Enough to beat you?
Well, I mean, I don't know about that. I mean, we're gonna try to give it all the juice. All
right.
I just don't know if it's gonna have enough juice for old Mater.
Old Mater.
Mater's mean.
The Lightning McQueen, ka-chow.
Ka-chow.
Ka-chinga.
Well, it's gonna run better than what it did before.
Plug the fans for sure.
Huh? So the time is here. We're gonna do an all-motor tune, baby. All-motor tune. This is fun. My truck has never been on a dyno. New na truck, it's my first truck ever on a dyno. Las otras eran puro straight tune, you know what I mean? You just plug in the computer, go to the street, test it out. That's it. Over here, dyno tune.
But not just anybody can come here.
Nah, not just anybody can come here, that's right. That's right. If you want a tune by Flaco, you gotta hit him up. You gotta be within his schedule, and please don't be late. I'm late, but it's all right. I got cheese skis here. Motor's a Texas Speed motor. Ooh, hey, shout out to Texas Speed, baby. ¿Qué le hiciste? Thank you. Every time he turns it off, I feel like he's gonna say something like, hey, wait, this truck.
Like everything on the fly, like all the adjustments, like what was idling with the Holley.
Yeah.
Like you add it on and you make all the adjustments and everything and, you know, get all the throttle tip in and everything right. HP tuners, you have to like click, upload, try it again, change it, try it again.
So that means we gotta go Holley in the near future. Makes everything easier.
Well, let's just make this one.
Let's.
You can worry about Holley later on.
Who's Holley? Best Red Bull you ever had. Hey, tengo center console, you guys?
Look, I can put
my phone
here.
Hell yeah. Mm-hmm. You know? Aquí andaba guacala
una vez sin asiento. Booster seat?
Yeah, no booster seat, nothing. No. Dale perrillo.
No pasa nada, pa. No. Los ganó una Ford, pa. No sé por qué nos ganó.
Guacala, te amo, putito.
Mexico! Canada! He's a pretty boy! He's a pretty boy! He's a pretty boy!
It's a wiener dog! It's a glizzy dog! That's my truck. Oh, shit. Honestamente, tengo miedo.
You're gonna have more fuel? Yeah. What is your passenger seat?
Race
car, bro.
No passenger.
Okay. Except guacala.
Except
guacala.
Oh, yeah.
Oye,
cae
de
perrillo,
¿es tu el
carro,
güey?
¿Te cae luz o lo que?
No, güey, no. Vamos a terminar en la casa que compró Flaco. We don't want that.
Yeah, good thing I got plenty of trees over there to stop it.
Que no se atraviese un wiener dog, güey.
I'm the best there is, plain and simple. I mean, I wake up in the morning, I piss excellence.
Onta la mater.
Mater, wait.
Yo soy el bull that when they're running through the field, that bull chasing Mater. See? I watch movies. Ah, damn, this thing is thick. Thicker than a bowl of oatmeal. Some GTR. Ciao, Mater. Yeah, so we got Flaco master tuning and everything. Like I said, Flaco's one of the best guys in LS. Holley, stock ECU, he's one of the best LS guys. He also holds a record. I'm not sure if he's the second or third fastest LS in the world, Craig, in the world.
They need security in the world, Craig.
Yeah. I mean, you can kind of feel whenever, like a 400 horsepower pull, you can feel vehicle itself being strapped down. I mean, you can kind of feel it, whatever. But once you start getting like in the 500, mm-hmm. you kind of feel like the vehicle wants to try to move, push forward through
gotcha.
The straps a little bit.
Yeah.
And then of course the higher horsepower ones, mm-hmm. they'll tend to move more and more and more. But just for being motor, I mean, it kind of feels somewhere in the range of what a 500 horsepower
damn.
Would make.
That's pretty good.
I think it's pretty good, though.
Fuck yeah.
I mean, a 408 with good heads and all that, I mean, I've seen 530, 540. That's,
right.
Like Tito's, remember the Tito's old black truck?
Yeah.
What is it, 08?
Yeah.
Remember that one?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's the motor he's got on the green one.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
That one was with fast intake and all that, made 530.
Right, all day. Yeah.
And it was a 402, aluminum block, trick flow heads.
Right. Okay.
So it kind of... You know, simulates mm-hmm. very similar to it.
There you go, Alex. You got yourself like a 500 horsepower truck.
At least, yeah.
At least, minimum. At the most, minimum.
That's
fine. So. That's without nitrous, too.
Yeah, nitrous. Just, I mean, how big a shot is it?
He said yes. How big of a shot?
I got 200 shot pills, but with the two, I'm probably gonna do like 150.
Yeah. No, I mean, normally a 250 on a 408 that makes 5 to 520 will make about 750 on a 250 shot. So, I mean, if you put 150, yeah, it's going to be about maybe 650.
Is that a call out?
Somewhere in there. But I know like a 5 to 520 on motor, and then you put a 250 on it, it'll definitely make 740, 750.
Right.
That's pretty good. Yeah.
Cool.
You're gonna beat Shelby's?
Hey, bro. Yeah, Shelby's better. Watch out with this sleeper right here. See this thing pulling up? You better watch out, Shelby's. Talking to you, Beto. Nah. Nah, then Beto's gonna go some crazy 1,000 horsepower thing. He'll be like, it's still a Shelby. Spicy tuna, baby! Bien spicy meatball voy a andar, para que sepan.
You should be able to catch traction, huh? On a roll?
Yeah. Especially with them slicks. We don't got drag radios no more.
I know where those slicks are from.
From where?
Slicks. Funny.
Damn right, these slicks were all over the road in an airfield. I forgot. So these slicks used to be on Gambang. But since Gambang got new tires, they didn't really need new tires, but just for the sake of it, we got some new tires, and I decided to slap these on, you know. Beto was like, hey, ponselos a tu troca, say less.
Hey, V, line them up.
And we got some juice.
We got some juice.
You ready, bro? This is the very fun part right here. When you put the juice, a little power adder, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna go scuba diving. Yeah, big shout out to Nitrous Outlet. Actually, you know what? Big shout out to Nitrous Outlet. My boy Vic and my boy Rudy out there, they hooked it up. They always been hooking it up. Big shout out to Nitrous Outlet. They provided me with the nitrous kit, of course, bottles, whatever I need, fittings. I hit them up and they're quick to answer. So big shout out to Nitrous Outlet. Team Nitrous Outlet, baby. Be nice.
Make sure we have, I didn't even know what bottle pressure yet.
Good.
What do you
mean you're
good? You're gonna heat it up. Yeah, but how do you know how much you're gonna heat it up for?
I've done it so many times.
Do you know what bottle pressure is optimum?
First of all, I don't even know what optimum means. So that's elaborate.
That's the internet, the internet company. So make sure to put your gauge next time. That way it reads 900 PSI. I mean, you don't want to have it like heated up to 1200.
Cause, no, because then it's, yeah.
Yeah, so 900 at all times.
Okay.
Put a little bit of heat on them, not a whole lot.
Okay.
And then are the pills, you don't even have a torch.
Hell no, I know. They don't let me around fires. Why? That's a good thing.
Why?
You don't want to know.
I do want to know.
You don't
know.
You don't
want
to know.
So, okay, so they're both full, so it's going to have enough pressure. Mm-hmm. Pills in the front, are we okay? It's got the correct pills?
Yes.
For the 150?
Yes.
Okay, which one is it?
That's the 175.
Okay, you'll leave 175?
Yeah. Open them.
Make sure.
They're tight.
Make sure you got no leaks. Open it all the way. You want all the pressure.
All the juice, huh? I'm OJ.
OJ.
Nah, hombre, güey, yo qué.
Al Mexico, papá.
You know Flaco has the Bronco?
He tuned it. What are those buttons for?
So, okay.
Turn it on.
Yeah.
No, that's open. Okay, hold on. What do we got set up already here?
Nothing set up, nothing.
Nothing is set up?
Nothing.
So is it just gonna hit 100%? Like whenever you floor it, it's gonna hit 100% already, or it's gonna have a ramp? You don't even know how to mess with it.
No, I haven't even messed with it. I think it will hit all 175.
Okay, that's all we need.
Okay.
Oh, it does show bottle pressure.
It does?
Yeah. N2O pressure, 725.
Oh. Nice. Ah, bien la computer.
She said.
You know, I mean, it's only at 125. You don't notice like a...
Yeah.
But I did, that was a third gear pull, so it's gonna be way longer pull.
Mm-hmm.
The other ones were second gear with the converter lock. This was a full third gear. So it kind of, that way we can get a nice graph on the nitrous. Feels good. I mean, I would put a little bit of pressure. Once you put a little bit of pressure, it's gonna actually hit a little better.
Okay, that's about 900.
Yeah, 900.
Okay.
Yeah. Anywhere from 875 to 900, you know. If it's over 900, I just kind of purge it down to 900.
Okay.
But, I mean, other than that, I mean, it's pretty clean and everything. So, nitrous hits nice and smooth and everything. Now, you might maybe put a ramp for the street, you know, like, you have to you have to read the instructions,
mm-hmm.
you know. And then put a ramp because, like, if you take off from a dead stop, it's probably going to maybe want to try to spin. So, maybe 50% and then kind of, like, ramp it in or whatever the case is.
Okay.
But, that's up until you put the time and retard marks.
Okay.
Not right now.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, it's got motor timing. I retarded it right here. But you're going to have to get that little box eventually. Whenever you turn it on, it actually sends signal to it, and it actually retards the timing.
Okay.
So, yep.
All the juice. So, we did a pull. We did two pulls on motor. It did pretty good. And then now we did a pull with the nitrous. You know, he messed with it. You know, I need another thing to add to this truck. That way the nitrous can work with the perfect timing, the ramp in the streets and all that kind of stuff. So, but for right now, the juice is loose.
Do you need me to find something wrong with it?
No, you're going to find a lot. You're going to find a lot.
You don't want that. You don't want those problems, though.
Because I'm sure we can find a problem with it.
Oh, I'm sure we can.
Uh-oh.
There's one.
No, you pass the test.
Hell yeah. I'm worthy.
So I'm going to bust that ass.
Yeah, I'm beating some 5-volt motor, you know, just hanging. On the older setup.
Oh, yeah? This ain't your regular 5-volt.
I know it ain't. I know nothing regular with you.
Hey, you better go ahead and... You better go ahead and take advantage right now because pretty soon it's gonna be blown.
I think 99 almost.
Pretty soon you're gonna need all the 250.
I'm gonna need some boosted juice.
You pass the test.
Hell yeah. That's why you bring chocolates.
Bro, you got it.
Put me in, Ricky Bobby. I want to go fast.
You don't need to see where we're going.
You got AC?
Yeah, just cruising. Cruising the neighborhood.
He asked me if I had AC. You got a window, that's it.
It even idles better.
Does it feel different?
It idles better. Cause I had, like I said, I had like a move around tune. Not something to hurt the motor, but something just to move around from the shop to my house to get some gas. But right now
you need a move around tune.
We got a tune. We got a nice little. Oh damn, baby.
Hey bro, I got no seatbelt though.
I don't either.
Got a seat too. Call the floor.
Aquí no, not the neighborhood.
We're gonna call out Wakala too right now.
Hell yeah. Yeah, call him out with the same call out. But not how he talks.
Yes or no?
make sure your truck is at 100%. No quiero excusas que... No, hombre, pero yo es que la troca está fallando. Ahorita la manejé y como que no, me da miedo. Your truck better be 100%, guacala. Official call out right here. Calling you out, boy.
Hey, the boys ain't around here.
We're gonna open the bottle.
Can't get out.
Pressure's still good. You know, that's the beauty about this little thing. It tells you everything, bro. I didn't think it was gonna tell me the pressure, but you know, it does. It's gonna ask.
Say that
first thing
I said, he's gonna be like, no big deal, let's just give it a little bit. That's the first thing he done did,
just like at the shop, bro. In one ear, out the other. Wait, what is it?
How you like that Red Bull?
How to run? Good, yeah. It pulls harder than before.
Oh, yeah,
really?
Oh, yeah, and the thing's fun.
I'm gonna drag it one day,
but first, I'm gonna beat him. You
gonna try.
I got a long way driver though, 4x4.
Is it?
Yeah. It's OBS, so we'll see. He'll probably catch up, but Wildcats should jump on him.
Uh-huh. Maybe beat me.
I'll tell everybody I beat Flaco.
Right?
Your truck will spin though, wouldn't it?
No, it hooks.
From a roll?
It hooks.
From a roll? On a 40 or a 50 or?
40, 50. Yeah,
yeah, no shit.
Yeah.
That ass. Should be a good race then.
Yeah, I know.
All motor. Yeah. All motor versus all motor.
Yeah.
We got to make sure we take the bottles out.
Yeah, we got to take the bottles out. He's going to cheat.
He's
going to be like, let me spray him. Yeah. I ain't even going to put slicks on mine or drag radios. I'm going to run you the way it is. Yeah.
Hey, that would be fair if you did, because you're on slicks versus the street tires.
We can do that. We got spares.
Yeah, we do actually. That'll make it more even.
Yeah.
He gonna let him sit overnight.
I know, Dr. Pepper, pimp juice, and everything.
Yeah, I know you are. That's fine. No, that Coyote, it spins, but it doesn't spin a whole lot because it doesn't have torque.
Right.
So it's all.
There's
power.
No low end power.
I know.
Yeah. Oh, there you go.
Yeah. Should and go. Then like if you hit it, say a 50 row, mm-hmm. 40 row. I mean, the R's are gonna be way up. I mean, I spin that thing 8,000.
Right.
Yeah.
Damn. And it's way lighter too, huh? Yours?
I'm pretty sure it is.
Yeah.
Then I mean, that thing probably weighs maybe 3,500.
Okay. Yeah.
It's a square tube steel frame, so maybe 3,500, 3,300, mm-hmm. you know, give or take. So it's obviously a little lighter than that.
Right.
Yeah. But I mean, it should be pretty good.
I think it'll be pretty even.
I mean, he's got a four speed. I got a 3 speed, but you know.
I guess we'll see. We'll plan it out one of these days.
Yeah, yeah.
Somewhere on our side, I guess.
Yeah, yeah.
Over there.
All right. So I'll put a sticker. Flaco perform. I'll put it on the motor. I don't want to embarrass Flaco if I lose, and I'll be like, I beat a Flaco performance truck. No, I don't need that. No. But I will rep
Later on, I'm gonna get a black reflective Flaco sticker, and it's gonna look badass. Over here, provided my boy Cheekies.
Already.
Cheekies. Let's bless the truck. Let's bless it. I'm gonna wait for the black one, like yours. But this, I don't wanna put my truck there and be like, I'll be the Flaco truck.
It's gonna be more like Flaco let you win.
He doesn't want to beat on a dog. That's animal abuse.
No, it ain't. You know, Michael Vick did it. So, I am now licensed. It's official, guys.
We just fired the person that does that, but now you have been promoted. You are now one of my elite employees.
Oh yeah. Damn right. Who drew a dick on my intake? It was me.
What's next?
Cosmetic.
You gonna clone it?
Yeah. So I do have an SS kit at the back of the shop.
I like it.
Yeah, we can tell, bro. We can tell. You also fuck them up.
I crash them and I fix them.
That's the beauty of them. They're fiberglass, baby. Shit.
No. What the
well,
fuck?
You can make fiberglass. You just fit it with fiberglass, baby.
No fiberglass.
No fiberglass?
Yeah, I have all of them. You have OEM.
I'm OEM. I have OEM. I do have OEM. So I think I'm done with the motor part for now.
Bubble eye clone.
Damn right. That's gonna look sick. Work on that. Work on the interior. Put some speakers, a little radio, just so I can jam. I'm not gonna be driving the truck much, you know, since it has no AC.
It's like a
but
take it to work on Fridays.
Hey, yeah, hey, ain't too bad. So we're working cosmetics and we're gonna be working on becoming a little bit more lightweight also, but.
You or the truck?
The boat, motherfucker. So we're gonna work on getting the truck a little bit lighter, such as maybe like a brake kit or other little stuff. But let's go talk to my boy Flaco and let's see what's up with him. Let's see what's cracking, let's see the deal.
Boy, hey.
Damn right, bro. So big shout out to Flaco Performance for, you know, allowing me to come over here and bring this little POS. But you know, it did its job. So real happy with the outcome that Flaco did. Not the numbers, but the way it moves. You know what I'm saying?
It moves good.
Oh, bro, I didn't want to say.
She got some moves. Then.
So big shout out to Flaco again, guys. Y'all make sure if y'all want some laners, some stickers, make sure to go down his website. He also has giveaways going on and he will have another one. So head over to flacoperformance.com, check him out. But that is it. Oh, wait, guys.
There's more.
The giveaway ends tonight. So stop the video right now. Go to ONDGAS.com, buy whatever, bro. Buy some combo pads, buy some stickers, buy some shirts. Get that 454 SS before it's gone. Legendary truck right there, so.
It's a badass truck.
Very badass truck, and it has AC. This one don't have AC.
Mm.
Carnita de Monte, ya sabes.
Yeah.
So, that is it for this video, guys. See you on the next one. Make sure to like, subscribe, and comment down below. Let's go.